IHGN Studios. It's Braves Beat.
Hello and welcome to our fourth episode of Braves Beat. I'm Irma Sardar.
And I'm Will Schneider.
Hope you enjoyed your short week, Braves.
Anyway, let's kick this off with a segment about our upcoming activities fair.
Yeah, man, we got Big Nick this week. It should be a good game.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, man, gotta go.
All right, see you later, bro.
Hey, Brave, I'm Amari Whitehead coming at you for the Activities Fair coming up September 11th, Durham Flex, sponsored by your leadership class. Freshmen will kick it off at 10:15, followed by sophomores at 10:30, and juniors and seniors will end it off at 10:45. Here's a list of the current clubs that we have signed up. If your club is not on the list and you want to be represented at the Activity Fair, please go see Ms. Masciatola at room 231. Thank you and have a good day, Brave.
Looks great, guys. Can't wait for the fair. Congrats to our students Jasper Bennett, Luke Castellini, Claire Hardick, Claudia Hollander, Gwen Yoshe, and John Cushman, who were chosen for Ohio All-State Choir. And we would also like to recognize Jesse Chan for being selected to participate in the 2020 All-State Band. Congratulations, Braves.
Here are your August Super Braves.
And the winner is Samara Summers. Congratulations to all of our Super Braves.
Next Friday, we celebrate Special Persons Day. Our seniors will bring in a special person and enjoy a nice breakfast. Whether it's your parents, grandparents, or friends, it should be a great time for people of all ages.
Braves Nation, would you like to host an exchange student this fall? As a founding member in the new Taiwan City Cincinnati Exchange Program, we welcome a group of students each October and we need your help to make this happen. If you're interested, click on the link in the description or simply just let Mr. D'Amadeo know personally.
The cross country team will be holding a school supply drive for Van Voorhees Elementary School on Fort Knox beginning Monday, September 9th through Friday, September 20th. They will be collecting these items. They are also collecting donations to pay for a bus so we can travel down to Fort Knox on October 14th. If you'd like to make a donation, please make checks payable to Indian Hill Athletic Department. Thank you for your support of the team's community service project.
Speaking of cross country, I had the chance to interview Coach Savage about her girls track team winning the Division II state championship. Let's check it out.
Hello, Braves. I'm here with Coach Savage, who coaches the cross-country teams and the track teams, and her girls' track team just won the Division II state championship. So I came here for a much-needed interview and to congratulate her, so congratulations.
We go into a meet. I had the same attitude going into the state meet. I don't pay attention to the state, to the scoring during a meet. They crossed the finish line. I looked at my watch, and I was like, that can't be right. Then it flashed up on the scoreboard. It was right. It was a state record. To have that happen, it was just awesome. The expression is it was icing on the cake. This was like 4 inches of icing on the cake.
Do you have any other favorite activities other than running, coaching track, and cross country?
So as an athlete myself, as you get older, you have to mix it up a little bit. You just can't run. So probably since 2005, I train for triathlons in the summer.
Why would you encourage people to join cross country or the track team?
I try to make the programs like a family. They understand how important it is to stay physically active as they get older, and I'm always thrilled when I hear from former student athletes who have completed a marathon or they're doing triathlons. Coming out for track or cross country, you may find that maybe that's not your gift, but there's something to be gained by participating in track and cross country, that you're a part of something.
The Braves volleyball team has been on a roll with big recent wins against Reading and Marymount. A special congratulations goes to Coach Hughes, who earned her 300th career win last week and has earned even more wins since then. Great work, Lady Braves. Be sure to come out and support the teams in their matchup against Goshen at home tomorrow. JV starts at 10 a.m. and varsity starts at 11 a.m.
Let's check in with some student government officers on how you can use Superfan at upcoming events.
Hey guys, my name's Pranav Rastogi.
And mine is Harrison Patty.
And we are your student body officers for a fantastic app called Superfan. Superfan's a great app where you can earn great prizes for simply showing and cheering on your Indian Hill sports teams.
You can get great rewards such as gift cards for your favorite restaurants, hydro flasks, game passes, free concession items, and even a pair of AirPods. Just come and show your support.
Come support your teams, theatrical events, and musical events, and do so with Superfan.
Have a great day, Braves.
The Dogmen silenced the New Richmond Stands this past Friday, defeating the Lions 48-20 in their first regular season game. The team was led by senior quarterback Frank Lopez, and the rest of the season looks very promising. The Braves have a home game tonight at 7 against the McNick Rockets. The theme is a blackout, so pack the student section in your best black attire and get ready to be loud. Go Braves!
Well, that's all the news we have for this week.
Be sure to follow us on Twitter, subscribe to us on YouTube, and email us with any school updates.
And as always,
stay classy, Indian Hill.
All right, Indian Hill, we're going to be doing a 30-second talent show. Let's go.
You got 30 seconds to do a talent. Go.